if everybody knows of it, you guys want me to spend like literally 1 minute and actually show you. I mean, there are lots and lots of tools online. I mean, you can download, but you know, if I should, well, let's put it this way, right? With simple tools which you can use without any programming or even knowledge of Photoshop, you know, they work very well, but of course we don't have as much power. And then if you want to go to the next level, you have to go download some software. But you want me to show you very briefly this very simple set of tools which I use with my students, which actually includes network diagrams?
Sure.
Okay. Da? Okay. Da. Okay. And again, if everybody knows about it, you just tell me right away. Sorry, this is my thing for tonight, so I've just been working on this. Okay, so do you guys know about mini eyes?
No?
Mini eyes.
No.
Wow.
You said it yesterday, but that's it.
Okay. Interesting. So maybe there's a real distinction between like West Coast and East Coast. No, it does seem like I have a completely different, very different set of references. You know, it's interesting. Well, maybe because I was really working on visualization.
You're in the lab.
Yes. Okay, so, oh. Okay, now, who's our internet expert? We don't want to start connecting.
So you just gotta do the same thing.
Yeah,
because we zap.
Oh, we zap, because we zap. Okay, we zap, okay. Okay, so this is, first of all, that helps, right?
Yes.
That helps already, right? Okay, sorry about that. And?
And manual DHCP.
It is connected.
It's connected.
No, it's
already connected.
It's going to give you a bad address.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, so
no, it might work.
No, it works.
It works.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so do you guys know about history flow?
No.
Okay, I'll show tonight. I'll show tonight. Okay, let me save something. You know, best things for tonight. Right? Yes. Well, it's for you, right? It's for you, right? Yeah, but then you get to discuss it with them tomorrow. Okay. So MiniEyes is a kind of project by Martin Gutenberg, who is one of these interesting people who has a kind of PhD in computer science, but also has been exhibiting his art projects. And then he kind of went to work for IBM in a small research center. And he also has a very interesting person who I think was a kind of graduate degree from Judith Donner from Multimedia Lab. And he kind of developed this idea of what we call a kind of shared visualization platform, which I'm not sure it worked very well in practice, but the idea was very good. So the idea was to create democratized visualization, and this was done, you know, maybe 3 years ago before Google Charts, because now you can also do the Google Charts.
Mm-hmm.
But Google Charts, for example, don't offer you right now, they don't offer you maps, they don't offer you network graphs. So what is really beautiful, very interesting about this project is that you go and you create your account, and then you can upload a data set. And data set is just basically a spreadsheet, right? Which can have two columns, three columns, etc. For those people who are completely new to it, I think it's actually the best practical introduction to learning about graphing visualization. Because for every type of visualization which we offer, we have a kind of whole page where we discuss it, and the page both is a kind of technical primer, but sometimes it also has little kind of theoretical snippets. So to that extent, MiniEyes is similar to programming, right? Which is both a tool for people to kind of
processing,
right? But processing, but also a whole, but it's also this kind of ideological and intellectual thing about this project. Okay, so if you look at visualization, so what happens is that anybody can go and submit a data set. The data set, by definition, becomes available to everybody, if there is no privacy setting. And then you can go and you can visualize your data set. And if you like your visualizations, you can save them. So there's like 36,000 visualizations here. But anybody else, any other user in the world can come and revisualize your data set. So it's very, very kind of beautiful and very, very progressive. So the idea behind it was that people will be revisualizing each other data and to them making discoveries. And my feeling, if you actually make some kind of graph, you'll find out that mostly people just visualize their own data. But despite that, what's really nice about it is that it actually offers, it actually right now, it can change tomorrow, right? But right now it offers more visualization types in Google Charts and even in Excel. And one of them is, so you have a lot of kind of bar charts, right? And, you know, stair graphs. But the reason I can recommend to you as a kind of beginning tool is that, first of all, it offers four different visualization types to do like kind of text analysis, not simply TechCloud, which is also kind of useful. It even does something which until now you really had to, you know, have some knowledge of computer science. It actually does a kind of phrase, some sort of kind of phrase maybe, you know, which is, I haven't played with it, but it looks very, very cool. So you can take a text and you can create this visualization of like the network of, I guess, words or phrases in this text. Another thing which it does, it basically has a world map visualization. I'll show you how I used it in a second. So you can do that. Again, it's not as powerful as Google Maps API, but again, it's easy to use. And also, it also has network diagram, right? So here's a network diagram. So maybe can I show you very briefly? So first of all, let me show you how it works. For example, let's say here's my contributions. So here's, let's say, different visualizations which I produced. So here's my visualization based on a project which we are working on with students, where we simply kind of collecting, visualizing the data about art biennials. So I made this map where I come up with this kind of somewhat of a, let's say, creative index, where I measure the age of every country by looking at if a country, let's say, has few biennials and it started before 1990, it's like old country, right? If a country has few biennials and it started after 1990, it's new country. Okay, it's an experiment, but it's something. Okay, so I kind of made this map, and then the countries are colorized depending on their age. And then you can see with visualization, every visualization directly links you back to the data file, right? So here's my data file. So here it is. And if I want, I can click on visualize, and then basically visualize it any way you want, right? So it's very, very kind of beautiful system. And, well, again, depending on, right, if you just choose arbitrary type, it's not really meaningful. So you have to kind of have some experience, but you can definitely play with it. So for example, we can say, well, maybe we can do bubble charts, right? And you can have as many visualizations of the data set as you want. So this is not really very meaningful. And then if you like it, you can basically publish it. But what's also interesting is because it's interactive visualization, you can even interactively control which column, right, maps into what, and when you publish it, it's interactive visualization, so it's actually interactive visualization for users. Yes, please.
I just didn't understand the way that was functioning.
Which part?
The bar chart, just the way that it was, what it was doing with the data.
Look here. Just a second. Okay, so let's say, okay, here's my contributions, okay. Well, why don't I just go and make the whole thing?
Okay.
Yeah? Okay. So let's go and, sorry guys, I know it sounds really simple, but if you don't mind. Yeah. Okay, so upload data set. It's like, okay, sure it tells you, right? Okay, so I'm going to take some, let's say, data set from the example which, you know, you guys rightfully took me to task last time, but seems like I earned some new favors today. Anyway, so I will dare. Again, just the data, okay? Don't take it too seriously. The data. Oh, this is this lookbook, but haven't cleaned this up yet. Okay, let's see.
You have to clean that manually?
No, what?
When you have to clean up. This cleanup procedure.
If it's 10 items, you do it manually. If it's more than 10, you write some kind of script, right?
Right.
Let me actually open this little database, which has data about the number of users on the lookbook per country, if I can find it. Just give me 1 second, it's okay. It's kind of, because I don't dare to open it off. But I may have to do it tonight. Just a second.